Hi, welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today I'm doing, I will call it an unboxing video, although it is not an unboxing video, it is not the box that I received. It's just something I got from a store that sells products in second hand. I like these stores that have these used products because often they are quite cheap and there are some things that I enjoy to get. And there are some days that just for relaxing, I believe I need to go there and just to check what there's around, and I have to buy them just to have it, to restore, to use, to give them a second life, or just to talk about them here on the YouTube channel, and then to write about it on the blog and to use and so on. So let's just see the three pens I got. So this is the just a little paper bag, and we have three pens inside, and I will show you one by one the pens I got. And I will start with this one. And what is this? I believe you all know. This is the very well-known now, as you can see there, the well-known Pilot Metropolitan. This pen is in quite good shape, as far as I could see. It cost 12 euros, and it has a medium nib. Why did I bought this pen in second hand? I made it because how can I tell you? This is a pen that I was never sent one in for loan for review, and I didn't have one. I also don't like that much the looks of the Pilot Metropolitan. There are lots of other Pilots that I really love, and there are even some entry level that I love more than this one, like the Kakuno or the, for example, the Vortex, which is a very insane pen. So I didn't I thought I wasn't going to buy this pen because it is too expensive. Here in Lisbon you may find a Pilot Metropolitan for such a price as 35 euros, which is quite a lot for that pen. And I didn't want to pay, and if I have to buy it online, there will be the shipping fees and so on. And I never wanted to invest this kind of money in this particular pen. The problem is not the brand, it's me that I don't like that much this model. But because this is so popular model today for the new users of fountain pens, today, everyone that wants to try to get in fountain pens, there are two pens that are usually recommended. Besides many Chinese pens, there are the Lamy Safari and the Pilot Metropolitan. So I thought it was a useful thing to have it for some comparisons to test it. It was very strange to be a pen reviewer and never have tested Pilot Metropolitan. So I have it here. I will start maybe to show the size of other pens compared with this one, but it is not a pen that I'm willing to love, although it may write very well. But okay, I just bought it because it was cheap and I think it has a great value for the work that I'm doing on fountain pens. The second pen was more like an irrational thing. It is this pen. And as you can see on the clip here, it has a little. On this clip, it misses some black. No. They are a little dirty. I have to clean them. This is a Cross Solo. It was kind of stupid to buy this pen because I already have one that I bought on the same store. Because some time ago there was a across solo that was like this one, but in yellow. And I bought it just to try it because I never tested a cross solo before. And I tried and I thought, wow, such a good nib for and such inexpensive pen. So I had the chance and I bought another one. And this is the white one. And I think if I see the other colors on the same price point, I think I will buy them also. This white one, I think it will look great next to the Pelican Stormtrooper pen. So maybe someday I'll have to make a group shot of pens that have black white white materials and black accents. And finally, another pen, and this one was a more rational purchase. It is a pen that I never saw on these kind of stores, and it is something that I'm really interested in. It is an Inox Chrome. The first pen that I bought with my own money was an Inox Chrome pen many years ago, and I really enjoyed it. And today I saw this one, and I thought, for 10 euros, it is nice and it is even boxed. So, as you can see, here we have the pen. Nice box. It says Inox Chrome over and over on the pen bed. It has the clips to hold the pen on place. It just misses two cartridges that would fit here, as you can see. It was very well designed, I think. And here we have the pen. The pen is very nice looking, in my opinion. It is in a very, very good shape. It almost looks like it was never used. It is in perfect condition. I'll have to clean it on the outside, but it is perfect. And it is an Inox Chrome 77. It's the name of the model. It is a Spanish pen. And when I saw it first, because it was unkept, it looked like a vintage or an old pilot costume from the 70s, which is very nice. Another thing that I find nice, it is this inlaid nib and the way the Inox Chrome is written when the nib is on its position. Usually the nibs are engraved like this. If you have to read Inox Chrome in modern nibs, you'll find Inox Chrome straight here. In this pen, it is facing down, which is quite nice. And this pen even came with the converter that looks a lot like the Parker 51 Neurometric pen. Very nice. I'm really excited for having this pen. I didn't test any of these particular pens that I bought. I have to see if they write well, and then I'll make reviews and talk about them. I'm really excited about this one, about the others also, because this one will be very useful for the whole thing that I do here on the internet. This one is just because it is a great pen and it works beautifully. And this one because it was so unexpected and it was a pen that I didn't know about, although it is one of the most well-known models from Inox Chrome. And that's it. With a very small cost and in a very short time, I made three purchases that I really like: a pen from Japan, a pen from the USA, although the nib may come from Japan, and a pen from Spain. Three different continents here in just three very cheap pen. The most expensive one was the Cross solo. This is all for today. I hope you'll keep watching our videos to see the reviews of all of these. And if you like this, please subscribe and keep coming back. See you next time. Bye.